There we go, at last. Anyway, so that's me. I'm Neil Maiden, as Vera said, from City University, and this work was done with two parts of what is now called the FCA Group, which was originally Fiat, now Fiat Chrysler, and in particular their subsidiary, Crane New Holland Industrial, who basically make tractors. And if anything else, I'm going to change your perceptions of tractors. When we started working with Fiat, they offered us lots of options, you know, working with Maserati product designers to stimulate creativity. But in the end, they said we'd be best helping out with health and safety. Once I picked myself up from the floor of the disappointment of this, it became quite an interesting domain to look into. And I think a lot of us now assume that advanced economies and societies, health and safety at work is a sort of done deal. We've solved the problem. But the numbers here indicate there are problems. You know, back in 2010, there were almost 5,000 workplace deaths in the US alone. And if you count the number of instances of 3+ work days lost in the European Union, it's a substantial problem. To overcome these challenges, both legislation and organisations have put in quite a lot of sort of cause-based reductionist methodologies for detecting and resolving risks, drilling down, asking sort of the 5W questions, identifying causes, and then sort of trying to come up with focused solutions that address the causal problems of the risk. And that's something that Crane New Holland Industrial had implemented in their plant in Basildon in Essex. This is a large plant. It's 400,000 square metres. It makes 20,000 tractors a year. That means one comes off the end of the line every 4 minutes. They are not your assumptions about tractors. Each one costs over €1 million, is bespoke, and can drive itself around a field using satellite. So it's stuffed full of software. It's quite a complex manufacturing process. However, even though the plant was doing well in terms of its health and safety process, they recognized that there was both a lack of employee engagement in this causal process, because they were basically identifying the same causes again, and regurgitating the same resolutions. The plant management perceived there was an opportunity to both introduce creativity to stimulate creative thinking about alternative risk resolutions to health and safety risks, as well as to enliven the process and enhance employee engagement again. So that was the challenge that we took up within this European funded project, and our mission was really to try and develop a piece of software that could be used on the production lines that would deliver what is known as little C creativity. This is local creativity delivering novel and useful risk resolutions within the context of a plant. So it doesn't have to be radically new. There may be a plant in Japan that does this, but as long as it's novel within the context of the process, that is enough. And these are not the pictures of the tractors they make, by the way, just in case there's any lawyers in the audience. I'll show you a real one later. So basically, my animation's gone horribly wrong here. I don't know what's happened to that, but never mind. The risk hunting application replaced a single A6 form that they would carry around with them in order to document risks that they would identify during the process. So I should explain, every employee who discovers a risk is responsible for first documenting it, recording it, and proposing a possible resolution, because they're the best placed person to do it because they're local, they understand the context of the work. So our job was to replace that with a web application that was optimized to work on tablets, so the solution was still mobile and you could take it to the place of the risk. It was linked in to a server-side repository of almost 10,000 previous risk resolutions. So we were actually developing quite a sophisticated back-end engine that was using creative search of thousands of the randomly selected thousands of these 10,000 risk resolutions each time, both to stimulate a basic case-based reasoning process, but also because of the creative search to look for something that's similar but different, so as to stimulate creative ideas about how to resolve the risk. And as well as that essentially computational service for advanced information retrieval, we also chose and worked with them as part of a user-centered design process, a series of creativity techniques that the employees in the plant felt comfortable with, which we actually then codified. So the basic process, which had a wonderful animation that's completely disappeared here, so you just get the whole thing, is in a process of 5 minutes, and I'll explain that in a minute, they would use a form to detect and record the risk, then generate a set of ideas that could be possible resolutions to the risk, compose them together, and then document the risk on a PDF, in an automatically generated PDF. Now, if that wasn't hard enough, dealing with employees on a production line, they said each employee's got to be able to do this in 5 minutes or less, because the tractor line doesn't stop. So they can't come off the line. So we picked ourselves up off the floor and decided how we were going to design this process. The last thing you'll notice is that unlike a lot of creativity support technologies that you might see in conferences like CHI and Creativity and Cognition, we went with a form-full aesthetic. There was quite a lot of discussion about this, about not undermining the seriousness of the work. When you've got a ton cab of lorry, of tractor, meeting a ton of chassis, people can lose their limbs. So there's a seriousness that we wanted to maintain through the use of the app and encourage uptake. So to give you a flavour of what it looks like on the left here, this is a sort of classic scene from the plant and somebody from the health and safety team just demonstrating the use of the app on these Galaxy tablets. And on the right-hand side, you've got a typical example of a very sort of classic health and safety form where a piece of the walkway is being ripped up and it becomes a very simple risk for tripping over, dropping things or falling in the way of a forklift truck. And there's lots of other things going on in the plant that makes it dangerous. It's full of autonomous vehicles moving goods and supplies around. It's quite a noisy, sort of vibrant place, and things move around quite quickly in it. So that's the context. And my animation, this is going to be bad news. Okay, so the animation's completely gone. Soddy and slide shark, I can't believe this. The form behind is when they would encounter a risk, they'd fill in the form, which you can sort of see behind. And the key thing to focus on here is they would write a natural language description of the risk that's encountered. So what you can't see there is a description of a risk where an employee lies on something called a duckboard, which is a bit like a skateboard, in order to go underneath the tractor to check for leaks and other faults before it goes out into the final stage, the garage. And we identified three different creativity techniques that were codified and put into the app. The first one is the idea of called superheroes, and you'll find it in the creativity methods literature. And it's essentially a form of extreme persona. So the app has about 30 different superheroes described in it with images. And the app makes recommendations about what they can do, imagining that that superhero is part of their team. So here we have Captain America, which I didn't choose due to the location. And he has lots of moral values. So the app is prompting, imagine he's part of your team. You want to do the most moral value-based solution. What would it be? And by pressing the green button at the bottom, you can generate the idea. And now it's completely frozen. It's going to be interesting. Let me just try. The other two. Description of the risk resolution that the user put in. Well, we might be there now. Yes. I'm sorry about this. This has never happened before. I use it for my teaching and everything. There we go. Oh, there we go. There's the description. There is the technique. The next technique is creative clues. So the tool is parsing what you've entered, and it's then generating creative clues about what you might do. So we generated 85 types of clue that were useful in manufacturing, which were derived from derivations of the TRIZ methodology, which identifies repeating qualities of creative solutions. So things you can see here is the tool's generating an idea, like think about try putting holes in the duckboard or to fill the duckboard with the holes in the duckboard, or think about evening out the environmental forces. And if those stimulate an idea in the employee, he or she can press the idea, and I'll show you how you document the ideas in a moment. Alternatively, you could also choose to use the creative search facility, and this at a time would represent five previous risk resolutions that were similar but different to the risk resolution that you came up with. So you can see there's one there. The second one on the list is called using duck, very simple description, and that's similar to our duckboard example. So by clicking on it, we would then be able to see the previous resolutions that were applied at the top, such as connect the crawler trolley or undertake some training. And then we also use the creative prompts using these qualities of creative clues again to generate further ideas. So at any point in this process, the user, which remember this is only 5 minutes, it takes me longer to explain it to you than it does for a user to do it, they would be able to click on an idea and up would pop a text box. Now, in early versions of this, we had an empty text box, and that was quite discouraging for the employees using the app on the production line to put in ideas. So one thing that we did after a while was, when you were using the creative clues, we would extract the essence of the creative clue, which was, for example, if it suggests evening out the environmental forces, you can cue the clue and the idea by taking that stem and say, in order to even out the creative forces, and then they just finish the sentence. And this was actually quite popular in this sort of queuing of finishing the creative idea sentence. So that was quite an important feature of the tool, as you'll see when I talk about the evaluation. Then eventually at the end, the tool just generated a PDF version of the original form, because they wanted the form to look like the other forms. So that's what the app did. So the question for us was this effective? So we posed two research questions that we examined through an empirical evaluation. The first one was the risk resolutions generated the app rated more novel and useful, i.e. more creative, than with the old paper system. And secondly, as a proxy for greater engagement, were the resolutions generated with the app more complete with the paper system? So we had access to the plant. So basically, it was the app was made available initially for 66 working days from March to June 2015. They were consecutive days. And any employee at any time could either use the app or the original A6 paper form. We collected data from various sources. So we collected function log data from app use. We looked at the risks and resolutions that were documented themselves. We conducted a few focus groups during the process. And we also then engaged with four senior risk analysts from the Fiat Chrysler Group from other plants across Europe in order to undertake expert ratings of the novelty and usefulness. So we sampled risks from a paper-based system and from the app. And they were blind to, the experts didn't know what was what, and they were asked to rate the novelty and the usefulness of that risk resolution for the described risk on a scales of 1 to 7. So it's quite a standard creativity evaluation method. So basically, our study took place in the first half of 2015, and as the comparator, we chose basically the same period in 2014. So there were similar weather conditions, there were similar production levels, so we tried to get a closer approximation as our baseline. So what happened? We being quite focused here and stripping out a lot of the data that's in the paper. Over the period with the app, there were 115 risk resolutions documented, and without the app, in the previous year, there were 119 by the same set of employees. So we only focused on a core set of employees in the plant because there are over 1,000 working in it. Excuse me. In terms of examples, the rather faint font shows you the risk description here. So a good, very simple one was the buggy driver leaping off his buggy before it comes to a standstill, obviously a dangerous thing to do. So a simple risk resolution to this was drivers to be advised to stay in the control of their vehicles at all times, not particularly creative. However, if you start to look at other ones here, this starts to get a bit more complicated. So here you've got a risk where an operator was pulling out an exhaust stack from a box and trapped his fingers between the stack and the metal bin. And you can then start to see that there's quite a sophisticated essence of ideas coming out from this risk resolution. And you can start to see that there are elements of the creative clues that the machine generated and put into the stem of the ideas box. So qualitatively, you can start to see you're getting more complex and complete resolutions. And this is another one, just to give you an example. You've got a relatively short risk description at the top and quite a long risk resolution, much longer than was the norm for the workers. So let's look at this more quantitatively. You look at the expert analysis review. Due to shortage of time, I've cut a lot of the stats out here. But basically, we get an increase, a statistical increase, in both the novelty and the usefulness of the risk resolutions that were generated with the app over equivalent risk resolutions generated with the paper-based process. These runs what scales of 1 to 7. You may have noticed that without the app, the mean rating was 2.44. So it's still not high. We've got it up to about 3.58. But over a first period of launch, that we thought that was quite good. This result was consistent with qualitative claims made by the health and safety team in the focus groups, and was achieved after quite a lot of initial employee resistance. We are basically talking with skilled manual workers here. And when some of these workers viewed the app to start with, there was quite a lot of expletives about what the effing hell we were doing, effing wasting their effing time with such a ridiculous idea. But over time, they started to see the value in it once they looked past the initial sort of qualities. The other interesting thing here is there seems to be no trade-off between usefulness and novelty. Quite a lot of times that we rolled out creativity support in design and other domains, there is a trade-off between you either get something that's more novel or more useful. The interesting thing here is we seem to be getting a win-win. So moving on quickly, we also analysed the word counts, basically, of the risk descriptions and resolutions. There is no difference between the length of the risk descriptions with and without the app, which is good. You don't have to do more work to describe the risk. But we do get quite a substantial increase in the completeness, or at least the number of words used to describe the risk resolutions, basically up from a mean of 5.6 with the paper up to almost 30 for a risk resolution with the app. And there's a lot going on there. I won't really talk about it. But the key thing you'll notice also that 80% of these risk resolutions were completed within the 5-minute period. I think the mean for this was 4 minutes and 46 seconds to write that much. So we can sort this was quite successful given the constraints of the work environment. We were really getting quite creative outcomes in short periods. We also looked at the app data, and there's an interesting feature here, which is that not all users of the app use the creativity techniques. In fact, about 40% of the users of the app to generate risk resolutions were actually just using the app as a paper-based, a digital form of the paper-based system without any of the creativity techniques. And when they did that, they didn't really get any of the benefits. So it's not the digitization of this risk resolution process. It seems to be the use of the techniques themselves. And if you then look at you could either use one technique to generate a resolution or two or three. The more techniques that they used, you'll notice that the increasing length of the risk resolution goes up. So the mean number of words to describe a risk resolution generated with all three techniques was almost 80 words, which is a lot for these guys to have to write. So again, interesting results there. And of the techniques that were used, it was the creative clues technique that was the most popular to use. And I think there are obvious reasons for that. So we looked behind and looked at why this was happening. And a content analysis of all of the risk resolutions indicated that over 90% included at least one instance of that stem text that we could trace back to the originating clue. So you can see examples here. This is taken straight out of their risk resolutions. You know, make the boxes move and adjust, generated by the machine, and they add something like area needs to be moved around to ensure all boxes, and that's their spelling, not mine, are situated within the lines. So what we're getting here is guided creativity thinking that is not only stimulating novel and useful outcomes, but is also driving you towards more completeness through the direct reuse of these stem clues from the creativity techniques. So in terms of conclusions, we think this was a successful evaluation in terms of the two questions. The app did increase the novelty and usefulness of the risk resolutions generated on the plant, and we think we got greater engagement. There's a number of threats to validity, but I would say that there was no evidence of other creativity training, no arts classes going on in the plant at that time. And of course, we have to be wary. We only have, at this stage, for this paper I'm reporting, one plant's data for 66 days. Now, having said this, we were successful enough that the app has continued to be used in the plant. And there's another paper at Creativity and Cognition, which is a much more qualitative study of the following 18 months. So if you want to come to Singapore next month. Moreover, we've had to build an Italian version of this and try to roll it out into Italian plants. So everything does the prose, the parsing, and the creativity management in Italian, which has been fun in its own right. So this has spawned a number of successes. So quickly finishing off, I think we've demonstrated an interesting new use of effective creativity support in an unusual work environment for this kind of work. I think one of the interesting successes is the app enables you to have optional use of creativity support. You can use the app as a bog standard replacement, digital replacement for the paper process, but at a simple click of a button, you can enhance what you're doing with the creativity support. Aesthetics and functions consistent with the seriousness of the work were really important here. And there's an interesting process whereby the resolutions, the creative process, became an aggregation of a collection of ideas that people had generated. And I apologize for the audiovisual problems. I will stop talking there and see whether there's any time for questions.
Hi, I'm Bert.